Good morning students, welcome back in our science online class. Today we are going to learn a second kind of simple machine, that is inclined plane. Actually students, what is mean by inclined plane? A slope is an inclined plane. You know slope? Slope area, you know? Slope area, slide, you know slide? Yes. So that sliding area is also called as the inclined plane. And what is the use of this inclined plane? So this inclined plane makes our work easy to load or unload objects. Underline, load and unload objects. So this inclined plane makes our work easy to load or to unload the objects. Load or unload. Next, an inclined plane is used to load a car in a truck to take it to different places. Factory manufactures the vehicles, but after manufacturing they have to sell to the agency who is going to sell these vehicles. So after the manufacturing of these vehicles, they load in a truck with the help of inclined plane. Load and unload also. The next one, a ramp for wheelchair. Can you see here? This is the ramp. So ramp is also called as slope. A ramp for wheelchair in the schools and hospitals. So this is the ramp. This ramp especially we can see in the school as well as in the hospitals. Okay, and this ramp is very useful. Okay, it is very easy to push a wheelchair on the ramp. So wherever you can see this ramp, so with the help of hands you can push this wheelchair easily on the ramp. One more example, this is the slide. You might have seen this slide in garden. Okay, mostly you enjoy by playing this slide. Now we will go to the next part. Now wedge. This is the third type of simple machine. Now what is wedge? Do you know students, knife, axe, fork, these are the examples of wedge. Now wedge means what? So wedge means, for example, a knife, a fork and axe. These all are the examples of a wedge. You can highlight with the help of pencil or highlighter. A wedge is thick at one end and thin, sharp edge at other end. So one end of this knife, axe is thick and second end is very sharp. And this sharp end we use to cut the vegetables. If you are using knife, the knife is used to cut the vegetables, fruits. If you are using axe, so axe is used to cut the wooden food or wooden blocks. Yes or no? Next, it can pull an object or cut into pieces. So these are the uses. Okay, different. So this spoon is used for another for this knife is used is different. Okay, an axe. Is it clear, students? So what is wedge? Wedge means sometimes question may come. Write any two examples of wedge. So you can write a knife or axe, or you can write fork also. Okay. And what is the second point? The one end is thick and the second end is very sharp. So sharp end mostly we use to cut the things. Okay students, now next part, screw. Do you know screw? So this screw is mostly used to fix the different parts. A screw is also an example of inclined plane. Underline. A screw is an inclined plane, but it is a spiral at one end and holds object firmly. Now, can you see here? This is spiral like marking is here. Whatever screws are there, you can see here spiral like marking. Okay? And these markings, spiral like markings, and holds the object firmly. This you can tighten it. A bar, a nut, bolt, ear studs are all are the examples of screws. Whatever the bulb is there, you can see here also spiral marking is there. So this spiral marking fits into the holder of a bulb. Okay. So I hope you understood today's part. So today we have learned the two kinds of simple machines. One is inclined plane and second one is wedge and screw. So these three kinds of simple machines we have learned today. Okay. Now today we'll stop here. Remaining two kinds of machines, that is a wheel and axle, and second one is pulley, we'll continue in our next video. Okay, students. Now next type of simple machines, that is wheel and axle. Now what is wheel and axle? Actually wheel means that is the rings. Okay, students. Now see here, this is the wheel. Okay, and there is a rod. So this rod fixed with the wheels. Okay, sometimes one or sometimes two wheels are there. So this structure is called wheel and axle. Okay, students, this structure is called wheel and axle. So when a wheel has a rod, now see here, these are the two wheels. So when sometimes one wheel, so when a wheel has a rod attached to it, helps in the movement. So this rod is attached to the wheel, and the rod is called, this rod is called axle. Okay, students. So these are the two wheels, and the center rod which is fixed to the wheel, that rod is called axle. And this axle helps to wheel, helps the wheel to move. This rod helps to helps the wheel to move. Means with the help of this rod, these both the wheels move, or sometimes one single. Okay. Then we find this type of structure wherever you can see. So in that machine, wheel and axle is used. Now, for example, wheel and axle machine in sewing machine and bicycle. You know bicycle? In bicycle also wheels are used. Okay, wheels and axles are used. The steering wheel of a car. Can you see here? This is the picture. And this is called the steering wheel. With the help of this wheel is joined with one rod, and that rod allows the movement of this wheel. And with the help of this steering, we can change the direction of our vehicle. Then next and last part of our simple machine, that is the pulley. Do you know pulley? Pulley is nothing. Pulley is again a wheel-like structure. Okay, this like structure is there, pulley. So a wheel which has grooves on it, and grooves, you know grooves, lines you can see. Grooves on it, on which a rope or chain moves to lift the object, is called pulley. This pulley is very useful to lift the water. Okay, to lift the water or to draw the water from the well. Have you seen? Sometimes this type of pulley is there. Okay, and here the rope, over this pulley rope is fixed, and this, with the help of this rope, we can draw the water, draw water from the well. So this pulley, due to the movement of this pulley or due to the rotation of the pulley, we can, without wasting energy or without wasting more energy, we can make our work easy. So this is the one use of the pulley. A pulley is used to draw water from a well. So you can underline, this is the example. Okay, what is the use of pulley? Pulley is used to draw or to get the water, to get the water from a well. The elevators in the buildings have a pulley on which they go up and down. The cranes also have a pulley to lift object, lift the objects. Second one more examples. You know the windows? That windows also, under that windows or the bottom or the lower side of the window, just you can observe, you can see the small wheel-like structures. And that small wheel-like structures also called as the pulley. Okay, students? So that pulley makes your work easy. So this is about the simple machine, students. I hope you understood all the different kinds of simple machines. So one more time, I will repeat what. There are six kinds of simple machines. First one is inclined plane. Then second one is weight. Then screw. Okay. Then wheel and axle and pulley. I hope you understood all these simple kind of machines. Today's homework, you read this part very carefully at home and prepare the different kinds of simple machines and prepare their one example where we can use these simple kind of machines. Okay, students? So today we will stop here. The remaining part of this lesson we will continue in our next video.